this week.
All right. How good it is to be in the house of God. Amen?
Amen.
Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Holy Father, we give you praise and thank you for the opportunity you give us to worship. As we gather in this little house of prayer, we ask you to bless what we do here, and may Jesus be lifted up. For it's in his name I pray. Amen. Amen. Brother Steve.
And good evening.
Good evening.
We'll take the hymnal and turn to page 189.
You to turn your Bibles over to the 7th chapter of Matthew's Gospel. Matthew's Gospel, chapter 7. And I want to look at verse 13 and verse 14 as a text, verses of Scripture. Notice what the Bible says here. Enter ye in at the straight gate, for wide is the gate and broad is the way that leadeth to destruction, and many there be which go in thereat, because straight is the gate and narrow is the way which leadeth unto life, and few there be that find it. Thank you, Lord, for your word. As we break the bread of life, use it for your glory and teach us those things that we need to know. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
I want to bring to you a message that is titled, The Two Ways. The two ways. If you stop and you really think about it, there are only two religions in the world. That which has come from the heart of man, and that which has come from the heart of God. don't know about you, but I like the latter better than the first. Amen. That comes from God is so much more important. That comes from the world or the heart of man is only an imagination. But that comes from God is a revelation. What a good that God loves us enough to reveal himself to us.
Amen.
And he does that through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Now, if you notice, in this particular text of Scripture, there are two gates, there are two ways, there are two companies, and there are two ends. Notice the two ways. Way number one is the way into life. Now, what does it mean? The gate suggests the idea of a city, a place of safety, a place of fellowship, and a place of plenty. The life which is in Christ is a life of safety from sin and wrath. Boy, it's going to be a good day when we walk through this particular gate and we won't ever have to worry about sin anymore.
Amen.
We won't ever have to worry about wrath anymore because we will be in full fellowship with Almighty God. And we'll be standing and basking in the presence of Almighty God. And oh, what a day that's going to be. We'll be in a place of satisfaction. You know, many years ago, one of the bands that a lot of people used to listen to had a song that had been written, "I Can't Get No Satisfaction."
Amen.
But I'm here to tell you today that you can get some satisfaction. And it's found in the fullness of God. So it is a gate. The Bible says here, a straight gate. So it is an open way. Straight. So that tells us that the door is not shut. In Revelation chapter 3, verse 8, the Bible says, "Behold, I have set before thee an open door." An open door. There are no back doors, friend.
Amen.
Into the kingdom of God. There's only one way. And Jesus made it very clear in John 14, 6. He said, I am the truth. I am the life.
Amen.
No man comes to the Father except by me or through me. So it is a straight way. A wide open door. And what makes it sweet to my soul is when the door opened, that it opened wide.
Amen.
For whosoever when Jesus hung suspended between heaven and earth, drew his last breath of life on this side of eternity, and said, "It is finished." The Bible says the veil of the temple was opened from top to bottom. What was once a closed door is now opened and will never be closed again unless God chooses to close it. And I don't believe he'll ever close it. I believe it'll always be opened for whosoever to come. So it is an open way. And then it is a narrow way for a camel to enter the gate. They had to be stripped of their load to get through. Man must be stripped of his own self-righteousness. His own self-righteousness will not be admitted. It is a narrow way that leads to a very large place. And then it is a way of the few. The Bible says in the text, few there be that find it. And the question comes to mind, why is there just a few that find it? Well, I'll answer that question, because there's only a few that will seek it. The Bible says, seek and ye shall find. Many prefer darkness instead of light. Others put off today, thinking that tomorrow will be the time. But the Bible makes it very clear. Today is the day of salvation, not tomorrow. The Bible makes it very clear. Boast not thyself of tomorrow, for thou knowest not what a day may bring forth. Amen. I never dreamed that January the 16th of last year would hold such a devastating day for me. But it can change. Your day can change in the moment and in the twinkling of an eye. You can be healthy as you can be one day and in the cemetery shortly thereafter.
Amen.
That's why it pays to be one of the few that find the way. Strive, the Bible says, to enter. In Matthew 6:33, the Bible teaches that if we'll seek him with all of our heart, that we can find him. Amen. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. In Jeremiah 29:13, the Bible tells me that we need to seek with a whole heart, not just part of our heart, but with all of our heart, so we find and we see the way of life. But then secondly, if you look at the next verse of Scripture, or the latter portion of verse 13, it says that there's a broad way that leadeth to destruction. So there is a way of destruction. Now the word destruction here means loss. It's like a watch losing its mainspring. It's like a plant losing the earth around its roots. It's like a man losing all of his privileges and his hope. Where is your hope? Have you built your hope on the Lord Jesus?
Amen.
You and I are a privileged people if we've built our hope on the Lord Jesus. The Bible says here it is a broad way. What does that mean? It is a way that suits the carnal mind. There's always plenty of room in this way. All of the things that the sinner lacks and all of the pleasures that they think this life can bring, it is filled with this world. It is filled with the flesh. How sad. Satan has full scope of this place. Broad. It is broad enough for those who are dishonest. It is broad enough for those who are unclean. It is broad enough for those who walk around in their pride. Understand, this place is a place of sin. And sin fascinates for a season. And then it assassinates and will steal your life away. Sin thrills for a moment, but then it kills and destroys. The Bible says that the devil, like a roaring lion, walketh about seeking those in whom he may devour. He's come to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But the Bible makes it very clear that Jesus has come to give us life and life more abundantly. Now this broad way is a crowded way. If you look at the text, it says, many there be which go in thereat. It's easy to walk down a hill. In fact, I remember a time whenever I walked up a hill, and it wasn't too easy to get up the hill.
Amen.
But then I turned around. And I started down the hill. And I like not to have been able to stop. In fact, I took a pretty good tumble as I started down the hill. Man's first choice, seemingly, in this life is to get on this broad road. But the thing that I want you to understand about this broad way is that it is a fatal way. There is but one possible end to this way. The Bible makes it very clear in the text that it leadeth to destruction. The Bible makes it very clear. The wages of sin is death.
Amen.
And the death that he's talking about in that verse of scripture is eternal separation from Almighty God. As we bring our study to a close, I like what the prophet Ezekiel said in Ezekiel 31, verse 11. He shouts out the message, "Turn ye, turn ye, for why will ye die?" What is he trying to say? Change your direction. Get off of that broad way that leadeth to destruction and jump onto the straight and narrow path that leads to eternal and wonderful life in Christ. And then the prophet Jeremiah said in Jeremiah 21:8, "Behold, I set before you the way of life and the way of death." And that's what these two ways have set before us. The way of life, the straight and narrow path that leads to the glorious splendor of heaven, a place where there's no suffering, a place, my friend, where there's no sickness, a place, my friend, where there's no death. We won't ever have to worry in that wonderful place that the straight and narrow leads to. We won't ever have to worry about going and visiting another funeral home.
Amen.
We won't ever have to put flowers on a grave anymore, because in that fair city, there is no cemetery.
Amen.
In that fair city, there is no death. In that fair city, there's no sorrow. There's no pain. There's no sickness. What a day it's going to be when we can walk into that beautiful place that God is preparing for those who have trusted him as Lord and Savior.
Amen.
So I don't know about you, but I choose the straight and narrow, the way that leads to everlasting life. As Jeremiah said, there's a way of life and a way of death. And as Jesus said, there's a straight gate and a narrow path. And there's a wide gate and the path of destruction. What path do you plan to take? I've made up my mind. I'm going to take the straight and narrow and make heaven my home one day soon.
Amen.
What about you?
God.
Amen. Father, we thank you for this study that lets us know that we can have the revelation of God, or we can follow the path of the world that leads to destruction. Help us choose wisely as we walk in this life. In Jesus' precious name, amen and amen.
Amen.